Hello, my name is Mike from Hunter Industries. In this segment, you will learn the basic steps to program an ACC controller. ACC is an advanced controller designed for large commercial sites. Even though this controller is very sophisticated and features an array of functions, the programming process is simple. If you know how to program a residential controller, programming an ACC controller will be a breeze. The programming process is virtually the same whether you use it as a conventional controller or a decoder system. We will start by getting familiar with using the controls and adjusting the contrast on the display. Then we are going to go over the main elements of programming a controller. These will include setting the date and time, programming overlap options, as well as setting start times, run times, and days to water. We are going to be using the dial to go through the different settings. Within each setting, we will navigate the display using the arrow buttons. When a particular value is flashing, we can make changes using the plus or minus button. The Programs button is used to advance from program to program. And the copy and paste buttons will help us accelerate the programming process by copying and pasting repeated values such as start times or run times. Before we start the programming process, let's make sure the contrast is at a comfortable level in the display and that we're running the most current firmware version in the face pack. The contrast is adjusted by pressing the plus and information buttons at the same time while the dial is in the run position. From there, use the plus or minus buttons to adjust the contrast. You can check all versions at once in the Advanced Features Utility Functions menu. We are now ready to program the controller. The first thing we're going to set is the current date and time. Turn the dial to the set current date and time position. You'll notice that the hour is flashing. Use the plus or minus to change the hour. Then we'll use the right arrow to advance over to the minutes and use the same plus or minus to make your selection there. Once the minutes are done, use the right arrow to go over to your AM/PM selection or 24-hour mode. Then use the right arrow to go to the month of the year. In this case, we'll select October. Use the right arrow to proceed to the day. Use your plus or minus to select the day. And then right arrow over to the year. And we'll select 2012. From there, the middle section is use daylight savings, yes or no. So we'll use the right arrow to advance down and select yes or no. And once again, use the right arrow to advance to the final selection, which is units of measure. You can either go English or metric. The next step is to set the start times for the program. However, before programming this section, you need to specify how you want your programs to run. You need to determine whether your system has the hydraulic capacity to handle the overlap mode. In other words, running more than one program at a time. Turn the dial to set program overlap options. Here you can choose among stack or overlap, smart stack, or SSG smart stack using the plus or minus buttons. Setting stack or overlap will allow you to choose at the set program start times dial position whether you want individual programs to stack, meaning one program at a time, or to overlap, in other words, to run multiple programs at the same time. Smart stack will allow you to stack the programs only after a determined number of programs are running together. SSG smart stack is used when you have stations programmed into groups to run simultaneously. This option allows you to stack programs only after a determined number of programs and a simultaneous station group are running together. This is an advanced feature which will be explained in further detail in another training segment. We will choose stack or overlap. Now turn the dial to set program start times. Here we need to specify whether we want program A to stack or to overlap with the other programs. The default is to stack. To set the start times, go down using the down arrow and enter the first time you want the program to start using the plus or minus button. If you want the program to repeat the cycle at a later time, you can set a second start time by pressing the down arrow button and adjust it. As you can see, a maximum of 10 start times can be programmed. If we press the information button while we are still in the start times position, a summary of the program appears showing the time that the program starts, how many start times it has, as well as the total runtime for the program. The next step is to set the duration for each station within the program. Turn the dial to set station runtimes. Notice that we are still in program A and that the seasonal adjustment value is at the default of 100%. To add runtime to station 1, press the plus button. The runtimes can be set from 1 second to 6 hours. You can use arrows to change the cursor position from minutes to hours to seconds. To advance to the next station, press the up arrow button and add runtime using the plus button. If most of your stations will have the same runtime, you can take advantage of the copy and paste function to speed up the process. With the desired runtime shown, simply hit the copy button, advance up to the next station, and hit paste, and it auto-populates the runtime right into that square. Notice that the actual runtime remains the same as the programmed runtime. This is because the seasonal adjustment is at 100%. If you were to change this percentage, the actual runtime would increase or decrease depending on the change. Just like in the start times position, if you press and hold the information button, the controller will show a report for each station, which includes the number of programs that the station is contained in, the total number of start times, the total runtime for the station, as well as the total gallons that the station will flow. The last element for a program to be complete is setting the days to water. Turn the dial to set days to water position. The ACC offers a variety of watering schedules, including specific days of the week, odd or even days, and interval days from 1 to 31, as well as optional non-water days feature, which can be used to omit watering on mowing days. To set the specific days of the week, press the down arrow button to start selecting the days to water. Use the plus button to water on a day and the minus button to not water on a day. If you wanted to program odd or even days of the month, you would go back up with the arrow to change the setting from specific days to odd even using the plus button. Then go down again and select whether you want to water on odd or even days using the plus button. This screen will also let you cancel the days of the week that you never want to water on, even if it is an even day, such as the 2nd, 4th, or 6th happen to fall on that day. To cancel a day, use the arrows to select the day you want to cancel and press the minus button to cancel watering that day. The other option is to program an interval schedule. To program this watering schedule, change the setting from odd-even to interval. Then go down and select an interval from 1 to 31 days. An interval of 1 means every day watering, 2 means every other day, 3 means it will skip 2 days and water on the 3rd day, and so on. Now go down to the next day to water to specify the number of days left until the next watering time. 0 days means it will water today if there is a start time later on. Otherwise, if the start time has passed, it will assume that it already watered today and it will wait until the next watering time. 1 day left means that it will skip one midnight and water on the next day. 2 days left means that it will skip two midnights and water on the following day. Similar to the odd-even screen, you can cancel days off in the week that you don't want the water to come on, even if the interval schedule calls for watering on that day. To cancel a day, go down to the day you want to cancel and press the minus button to say no. By pressing the information button within this dial position, you will be able to see an explanation for the setting that is selected, whether it is interval, specific days, or odd or even. This finishes the basic steps for programming a complete schedule. We went over the adjustment of the display contrast. We set the date and time and explained the program overlap options before programming the start times. Finally, we set the run times and explained the different options for days to water. There are many other functions that you can incorporate to customize your watering schedule. However, these will be covered in great detail in other videos.